Now, the Fire Phone is a rather unique device that sports a handful of cool features, including a dynamic perspective display, one for Euro Prime, Mayday, and Amazon's Fire OS 3.5, which is a heavily forked version of Android. Today, though, we'll be focusing on Firefly. Firefly basically is a direct link to Amazon's immense online storefront. It can access over 70 million products, from household items to video games and much more. But the feature goes much deeper still. Firefly can also identify printed text on posters, magazines, and emails. It'll recognize movies and TV episodes too. And it can also recognize songs so you can access artist info, all this with a simple press of a button. But even though Firefly can recognize lots of things, I found it to be incredibly inconsistent. It figured out the type of cereal I was shopping for, but only offered it to me in massive bulk. It turned our hazelnut syrup into either raspberry or vanilla. It logged the wrong kind of Gatorade, and many more similar examples. It couldn't identify my keyboard or mouse despite the fact that I bought them from Amazon. Most of the time, as long as you have the package or some kind of box, a book cover, a barcode, a big logo, Firefly will at least get close, but it's not nearly as accurate as we'd like it to be. Of course, this is just the first iteration of the software, so it's difficult to judge the device's performance. It is, however, better with other things. Phone numbers, URLs, email addresses, TV shows, movies, and songs. And its technology's potential is already starting to be realized. iHeartRadio is one of the main companions to Firefly too. It'll immediately start a radio station based on a song or artist, and it'll also find you tickets for the artist through StubHub. When it identifies a TV show, you'll get information about the show, the episode, that certain scene, and the cast in the show. Developers have complete access to Firefly's identification abilities too, so there's a lot of potential here. At least there will be, once Amazon gets a whole lot better at figuring out what it is the Fire Phone users are looking at. And that's it for this video, guys. We're still putting the Fire Phone through its paces before a final review, but if you want to hear some of John's thoughts on the device, we've included a link down below, and if you have any other questions, let us know in the comments down below. And as always, I'm Mark Lentang from Techno Buffalo. I'll see you guys in the next video.
Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe right here. Be the first ones to know whenever new videos get uploaded. We got a ton of stuff. We do phones, tablets, cars, anything that has to do with consumer electronics that has to be plugged in or uses batteries, we review.